I hope you're all safe and in good health. It is my great privilege and pleasure to be with you today and share with you a few insights from SCCA on the future of finance and ESG reporting. My name is Victoria Volotovska, and I'm a business relationship manager for SCCA Poland, Ukraine, and Baltic countries. Thank you for inviting me to the conference to deliver this presentation. I want to thank the organizers for such initiative, collecting money to support Ukraine. All civilized world understands that Ukraine is now a shield for Europe and all common value share. Please donate as much as you can. Every hryvnia matters, and please learn today what we can share as SCCA, a leading professional organization. So let's move on. As due to the internet, I will switch off the camera because it's my second attempt to record, and it shows that my face may not, you know, be black or half of the face. So I will switch off the camera and we'll proceed. Just to remind you that this presentation is built on two SCCA reports. One is ESG reporting, and the second was the future of financial specialist, you know, competences and knowledge. These reports are free and available on our website, so you will be able to access all the knowledge. And if you will decide, please contact the organizers. We're happy to share the presentation. Okay. The future, particularly as the pandemic has shown us, is never 100% certain. But what different SCCA research do tell us is that there is certain knowns, certain thematics that are see accelerating and which we will never have impact across organizations and all sectors as they navigate the way through the challenges ahead and exploit the opportunities. My presentation consists of 31 slides. I will be missing some of the slides because I'm not be able to present within the 10 minutes, you know, everything I want to share. Among the most important aspects of today's presentations are related to the environmental, social, and governance reporting. So please join me in this journey through basics of the ESG and integrated reporting. Let me start pointing that even after pandemic, when all supply chains are changing, the companies face issues regarding the components. We still live in the most globalized world ever, and the pandemic is still, you know, perceptible proof of the globalization. In the last ACCA report, our chief executive, Helen Brand, also mentioned that they already feel the impact of the war in Ukraine. In whatever country you are, it doesn't mean that if you don't feel the impact now, there is no impact. So we all as one have to stand up against this war and was sharing this knowledge and share what my impact on the ESG reporting. And it says like climate, environment, everything that my impact. Probably I think that war is my factors. It's the trading war, you know, lack of water, hunger, trade war, wars, hybrid wars and regular wars, riots, migrations, you know, especially nowadays. And there is also a climate crisis. And let me, you know, be straight about it. It is definitely that the human influence has warmed the atmosphere, ocean and land, as the report says. The next slide, I will not focus a lot. It's about the journey of the reporting story, which says that financial reporting was less complicated than it is today in 1960s. Financial statements, data analysis included two columns, what we have, what we owe. A profit and loss accounts showed a company's revenue and expenses over a particular period of time, its assets and liabilities. The situation did not change for many years. The reports began to appear presenting other data about the company. The next slide will mention that all you get used to the standardized way of financial reporting and accounting principles depend on your engagement. You follow local regulations and probably one of the above. I'm sorry to tell, but the future is different. I want to say a couple of words about this slide. Please take a look. Already 614 different sustainability reporting requirements across 84. The agreement for the global tax resolve international taxation of digital economy has been agreed at a huge pace. Certain multinational enterprises will be subject to a minimum 15% tax rate effective from 2023. So what to expect? Standardized requirements and more climate disclosure obligations in the coming years? The question is no, if we should at least prepare to report, but rather how we should prepare and, you know, and start reporting. Next slide is to mention that there is a growing need for high quality, non-financial disclosures and ESG reporting. Companies that disclose information regarding sustainable development do not provide all the information relevant to stakeholders. Disclosures are often not sufficiently reliable or comparable between the enterprises. It is difficult for users and to find a rarely available and readable digital format machine. Businesses do not disclose enough information concerning intangible assets, although this is the most common one, the private sector. Investors are more aware that issues related to sustainable development may threaten the financial results of enterprises. Please pay attention to policy, legislation and regulation, global initiatives, the task force for climate-related financial disclosures, and pressure of the investors. And that power about the power of the people. And last but not least, consumer pressure, opinion, and purchasing decisions are increasingly potent forces influencing how organizations approach climate and, you know, nature-related risks. One 2019 academic report found that from 2013-18, products in US marketed as sustainable grew more than 5 times faster than products not marketed as sustainable. And there's also risk if companies do not prove its social conscience. According to the Oxfam report, 1,000 richest people in the world have fully recovered losses in 9 months of the last year caused by the COVID. For the rest, it will take at least 20 years. And we're moving to ESG factors. I will be just enumerating that because the details are in the report. So what does the ESG reporting mean? ESG reporting is the disclosure of data explaining a business impact and added value in 3 areas: social and corporate governance. Of course, you should distinguish between the factors of financial and non-financial analysis, but it's worth noting that there are some elements in financial and non-financial reporting are the same. And of course, all of them drive the company to increase the market value. The next slides, we have like ESG factors as well available in the report, so you will have a look at them later. ESG materiality. In financial reporting, a threshold for influencing the economic decisions of those using an organizational financial statements are investors. ESG reporting concept is similar, however, in several dimensions, which are mentioned below. Materiality remains crucial. Impact and stakeholders are perceived widely, not of equal importance. ESG does matter. As well, you will have a chance, you know, to find in the report or okay. And I would like to mention on the ESG reporting for investment, important aspects. They are verifiable, clear and concise. Materiality is perhaps the single most important factor to consider when preparing the ESG disclosures. Objective. Comparable and reliable, strategic and forward-looking, and I put into the last point, but materiality is perhaps the single most important factor to consider when preparing the ESG disclosures. Applying a rigorous materiality process helps to identify relevant ESG issues and priorities to them according to the likelihood and magnitude of their potential impact on companies' operations. So we're now coming to the part of building the report. And I would like to mention a few important aspects. As a first step, it is helpful for a company to identify who is the audience targeted with this report and what do they want to know. To do so, the company should consider of this reporting exercise. Who do they target with this report and what are their needs? Based on the targeted audience, a company that defines which information is material to report defines which information is decision useful and necessary for understanding of the company's development, performance, and impact of the quality. So it should align with the minimum disclosure requirements. Consider additional sector-specific risks and opportunities. Tailor a set of KPIs to your company and prepare the report. What are the key success factors? As we're constantly running out of time, let me only say that preparation is the key. Relevant IT system is able to collect data, proper timing, and engaging process for all internal and external stakeholders are the most important. Here we're slightly coming to the web, to the slide where which is taken from the report about the future professional specialists' qualities and competences. FCCA member who is the president of IFAC said, over the past 5 to 10 years, society expectations have increased and organizations are being called out of what they do more than ever. People are demanding to see businesses demonstrate their purpose and to hold themselves and each other accountable. The next slide is showing the accountability 7 priorities for profession metrics. You'll be all but as well find them in the report, but I would like to mention a few of them in the future when it comes to the reporting. Building resilient economies, developing the talent for tomorrow, sustainable business, advancing standards and regulation, transforming the public sector, supporting entrepreneurial growth, strengthening ethics and trust. So when we talk about the accountability and we tell the company should be accountable, first of all, people should be accountable. Accountability starts from personal, from the person, where the person is accountable for everything he or she does in their life and the results and the consequences of this life. Then these people come to work for the certain company. And then there is a question where their values are same. So it's also important to find the right people to them to work with them and share the values that you have in the company. So how can companies prepare to be perceived better and how to report? I will have some keynotes what to do to, you know, to perform better. Designing the ESG strategy to attract investors. ESG gap, performing detailed, you know, inventory of ESG factors. Provide impact measurement for reporting and assessment, developing the necessary elements, identifying gaps. And here we comes to, here we come to the business results. It will pay off. Your business will become more sustainable and perceived as a reliable and accountable. Your risk management will be definitely deeper and more factors will be taken into account. You will meet market expectations and growing demand. And even if this might seem irrelevant, as business is to provide profit, you will develop a new social initiative. Here is the website, slide with the questions. I will not mention all of them, but I want to ask you to ask yourself the following. Are climate and natural capital risks a specific board agenda item? Why? Does the organization understand the full cost of climate risk to it? Does the organization understand the new business opportunities that might arise from climate and nature-related business strategies? So I'm not going to read all of them, as I said, but please refer to your conference materials where you can find all the presentation. And as well, you have an access to the whole report when you can also find yourself this question. In the beginning and the last of the presentation, I've been trying to outline how the business landscape for all organizations will be reshaped by imagined climate-related risks and opportunities. See, we'll have to balance many different considerations. They will also have to balance different paths as they prepare their organizations for this shift in how they think and operate as they do so. There are some immediate steps they can take. Get executive level buy-in for the climate action. Ensure that climate-related risks are fully integrated into the business strategy. Integrate ESG, climate KPIs and risk considerations into decision-making from strategic to operational level. Reporting, it is, you know, time to consider financial and non-financial reporting into accord so organizations can account for real value to society. Assurance, the accountancy and finance profession has developed robust and trustworthy assurance processes. These need to be adapted to integrate non-financial reporting, educate and rise the level of knowledge and expertise among all employees, and in particular, the finance teams on the importance of ESG and climate actions. I'm aware that the list of responsibilities only grow, but the above should be among those new tasks to be delivered as a priority along with business sustainability and growth, digital transformation and other relevant to your particular sector and situation. So on this point, I would like to thank you for attention. Thank you for your questions that might appear. Thank you for spending these, you know, 15 minutes, I hope, with us. And I would like to thank that all of you, all of us may not, you know, say how much do we thank and thankful for everything you do for us. It's hard situation for our country and for our people who might be in Ukraine or beyond, but we try to do something every day to help our country. So please excuse if we are sometimes so sad, not having time to say thank you, but I want to hope that we will stand all as one and everything you do is really very, very much appreciated. So thank you for your attention. I will be happy to answer all your questions that you might have. Bye-bye.